a hash function, basically, as we said, the input is a password. This box is the hash function. Whatever computation goes on here is going to happen here. And the output, this password could be any length. Could be a passphrase that combines a bunch of words, letters, digits, whatever it is. But it produces the hash value is of a fixed length. In this direction, we said it's one way, so it's easy to go. It's easy to compute this function given this input and for us to produce this output. If you just had this and wanted to invert it, go in the other direction, that's going to be really hard, which is the basis of what we're talking about here. Given that we're going to derive something from a password using a hash function and store that, let's talk about a couple of threats. Because of the security mindset we have, anytime we sort of make a decision, we want to think about its security implications. So what are some threats? We are going to assume that the one-way property of the hash functions holds. You make some assumptions. So we are going to assume that inverting or going in the other direction from a hash value to a password, we're not going to worry about that. Let's say we are talking about common passwords. You know that password is a common password, or 12345 is a common password. But this hash function is known. This one-way hash function we're talking about, we're not doing security by obscurity, so it's known. We can compute the hash values of the common passwords. And we're saying these hash values are stored by the system. Those are the derived values. If we can get hold of the hash values that the system has, and if we can find the hash values for the common passwords among those stored values, it's not hard to see how we can find out passwords of certain users in the system. So if the hash value for 12345 matches with the stored value, we know that user's password is 12345. The other kind of attacks we can mount, one is called a dictionary attack. So it's like a dictionary has lots of words. Think about a long list of passwords, a dictionary of possible passwords. Words, and maybe they are mutated in a certain way. You add a few digits or something like that. But you have this whole space of passwords or the dictionary of passwords, and you can try sort of brute force each one of them. That's called a dictionary attack. An offline attack is one where we're not interacting with the system. We're not trying to log in each time we try a different password. If you do that, then that's called an online attempt we are making. We are interacting with the system. So when you do an online sort of guessing attack, then the system can stop you after a certain number of tries. It locks you out. So to avoid that problem, we can sort of offline in our free time, we can take the hash values, take a dictionary, and sort of compute for each dictionary word the hash value and search for that in the set of hash values that we have. When we find a match, we know a password. And we can do this, as I said, without interacting with the system. We interact with the system only when we discover a correct password. So those are called offline attacks and dictionary attacks, sort of brute force attacks. So one thing, even when we store derived values, in particular hash values here, these kind of attacks are always possible. Common password, the hash values, dictionary, or offline attacks. The assumption here is that the attacker does have access to the hash values. The hash values don't immediately allow him or her to find out the password. They can try different or try to guess the password that match. And when they run into a match with the hash value, then they know for sure that this is the password. So these are kind of attacks that are possible even when you only store hash values.